We got zero people subscribing to us and followers.
I didn't even think this was stupid.
Please listen to the Professor for your amazing shows.
The Chicken Professor Show.
To Grease Pole Festival. So we have a huge, huge movie section coming up, everybody. But precursor to the huge movie section, we have this, whatever this is going to be. I have no idea because it was so many years ago. Oh, we need this. Okay, this is the instrument I want in our band.
Okay.
Do you actually know the name of that instrument? It's in. It's on the screen if you don't know. I'll tell you in a second if you don't want to read. Hurdy-gurdy, everybody. Metal-gurdy. I like how she laughs at that.
That was really cool.
To be quite honest, it's as good as any other metal band I've heard. I'll be honest. She took it a little bit more seriously.
Right. You know who I feel like could really benefit from her being in, like, their band or show?
Ooh, who?
That Lindsay Sterling girl
the violinist. Yeah, I'm a huge fan of her.
And she like hangs by her hair and stuff like that. If this was in it and she was doing that, yeah.
Oh yeah. No doubt. I think it's a good crossover. We should hook them up. So have your agent call their agent, and then their agent can call their agent to get a hold of the other agent. And then they'll just talk to
each
other on the phone.
You heard it first here on the TP show.
TP show. Let's check in with two animals that sound like Kevin Hart. Two animals.
All right, two. All
right. Not one. Yep. Not three, but two.
But two.
Walter. We are taking turns sitting in the back seat. Everybody else sat in the back seat. Walter.
I don't want to sit in the back seat. My name's Walter. I make blue meth. Why are you putting me in the back?
It sounds like Kevin Hart.
We are taking turns sitting in the back seat. Everybody else sat in the back seat.
Well, that's good for everybody else, but it's not good for me.
All right, I got it.
It doesn't
work
for me.
Play the audio. Right. Hey, Kevin. Hey, we're going to put you in the back seat in the child seat, okay?
We are taking turns.
You sure?
In the back seat.
Kevin,
everybody,
I mean.
Nobody puts baby in the corner. Nobody puts Kevin Hart in the back seat.
Stop it, Kevin, or we're not going to get you that Happy Meal.
Well, you know why Kevin Hart has to go to the back seat, right?
Why?
He's the only one that can get through. He's so small. Like, he's the only one that can, like, get through there.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Now I'm just waiting for Kevin Hart to rag on me for 3 hours, because look at me. I mean, come on. He's got tons of material.
Do it, Kevin. I dare you.
I don't dare you. Please don't do it, Mr. Hart.
I dare you. Yeah,
Mr. Hart, please
don't
dare.
Double dog.
No. Don't dog or dare or any of that stuff.
Yeah. I quadruple dog dare you.
Mr. Hart, I apologize. And now that you've been triple dog dare, I'm out of luck. So have at the crazy white guy with the crazy beard.
No.
He really does sound like Kevin Hart.
What is it? What?
Again, Mr. Hart, I apologize that animals sound
Everyone
like you.
Everyone said that you're trying to tell me something.
No, it's listening. A good thing. They all want to be
I'm
like
listening.
Kevin Hart.
Well, that's a good point.
What do you
Who
have
doesn't
say?
Want to be like Kevin Hart? I'll be honest. Rock
I mean,
your
this
best friend.
Favorite Uno. Movie is Get Hard.
You're
so.
From Philly.
What is it?
Yeah.
I don't like that. No.
What we have to do, though, is, and we got to figure it out, we got to isolate just the one side of the audio, and then we can add in the rest of the conversation. Yes, Mr. Hart. Yes, Mr. Hart.
Yeah.
No, Mr. Yes. Hart. Immediately, Mr.
Jumanji 3. Yes, yes.
Yes, Mr.
Jumanji.
Yes, Mr. Hart.
Needs to happen. Yep.
We need
you and the Rock.
In our lives.
We're gonna do it. Uh-huh.
We need it in our lives, people. Jumanji 3. I wonder who the holdup
really
is on that, by the way. Because that seems like a franchise that's a no-brainer for greenlighting. I'll just be honest.
Right.
But then again, if you think about it, when that first came out, when the original, like, remake of Jumanji came out, Kevin Hart wasn't huge yet. Rock wasn't huge yet. I mean, they were huge, but they weren't at the level they are now. The girl that plays, I'm trying to think of the girl that yes. plays the karate expert.
Yes, that girl.
She does the dance fighting. She's also in Guardians of the Galaxy 3, which is coming out soon for anybody that's paying attention. She wasn't huge yet either. She was pretty much a nobody. And of course, Jack Black was Jack Black.
Jackie.
He's always been Jack Black. So, I mean, that's really that. So what's this one?
So after watching the whole Congress bullshit about TikTok, I'm really concerned about how much they don't know how internet works.
Yeah, how does the internet work again?
I'm really concerned about how many of them were talking about how many children are dancing on their For You page.
Quick question. do you have access to my Wi-Fi, TikTok? What? Like, that question blew me away. And yeah, when they started talking about how disconcerting the For You page is, that it's all children dancing. We've had a long discussion about this 3, 4, 5 years ago, that the For You page is for you, for you. It's not for me. It's for you, which means if you're watching a lot of kiddie dancing videos.
That's concerning.
Yeah, no doubt.
So after watching the whole Congress bullshit.
You know what's funny is, did you hear the one guy explain how what happened there? This is my favorite answer I've heard from a politician in a long time.
I won't get it right, so go ahead.
He was doing research.
Yeah, I thought so. Yeah, I was going to say something like that. Yeah.
I'm doing research into being a pedophile, and I need to check out all these small children, because, you know, that's what pedophiles do, and I wouldn't be doing that personally, but, you know, got to check
You know, how did my pants go down? I don't know. Yeah.
And you wonder why priests wear robes, and you wonder why priests wear robes. That's all I got to say.
Yeah, you know, they just moved to a different city.
Absolutely no way dude is getting this thing on air.
I give him props for trying.
I know,
I like the fact. Oh, okay. I was gonna make them do it. I would have been like, "You guys got to get this on here, not me." I put Do Not Disturb on. Why are you disturbing me?
The drill is like legit.
This guy's got thinking.
He's building stuff,
dude. See, dude doesn't believe it either. It's pretty amazing, honestly.
I've heard of worse ideas.
All right,
we've seen worse ideas.
Whoa,
let's
building
be honest.
A whole palette.
Yeah, he is.
Straps.
Okay, I'm waiting for the first 3 feet when it all implodes. That's what I'm waiting for.
Right.
There's like zero. I like the old guy walking by. Like, here's the old guy. Here's my old guy interaction.
All right.
That guy's an idiot.
What in the Sam hell? Hey, Betty, look at this asshole here. He's been shitting on our lawn for months, and now he's going to put a TV up on his bike? No way.
I told you about your bad language, mister, but I agree with you. That's some shitty town right there.
Work. Clearly, dude.
Clearly.
How big is that TV?
Clearly.
65-inch TV carrying on a motorcycle.
You mean the motorcycle's being carried by the TV?
Honestly.
Right. Oh, he's getting out. Good.
Well, he's got to find out how stupid this guy is.
Dude, do you need any help?
I got a car.
Do you need any help?
Sorry,
do you need any help?
No, I'm good, man.
Honestly, I was amazed watching you, dude. Do you care if I video you doing it? Like
you're videoing?
Yeah, you care? Or...
Nah, it's good, man. It's good. Yeah. Okay.
It's good. It's good. I want proof that I made it. I want proof that I made it. Is that a Harley, by the way?
What's your name, man?
Charles.
I can't tell.
Charles, you mind holding that for me?
Holding this
strap right there?
Yeah, I'll hold it. I'll get it. You want it in the middle, right?
Yes, sir. I don't think this is gonna work. But...
All right. Well, at least
I'm excited.
Strapping it in.
I'm excited to find out.
All right.
Oh, okay. I couldn't tell. It looks like Harley Davidson wings, or is it?
I'm gonna try.
Maybe I.
Everybody's wishing him luck.
Yeah.
Good luck, moron. I mean, idiot. I mean, good luck, nice guy.
Here, let me set my phone down. I'll help you.
I've seen dumber ideas. I'll be honest. I've seen dumber ideas.
Okay. So right there. And then you want me to do the strap it around it.
Good. Okay.
So far, so good. I mean,
this is
his insanity
legit.
His insanity is pretty
All right,
logical.
Well, right. I mean,
you
Yeah.
Good luck.
Of course.
Can you put that stuff in the bag?
Oh, yeah.
If I get my butt up, then it falls over.
Yeah, yeah. No, I got you. I got you.
I mean, if I get really my butt up, prepared. It falls over.
Yeah, there we go.
There you go. All right. That's all, dude.
Thanks, man.
All right.
All right, let's see him go.
He actually did it.
Yeah,
folks.
I want to see. I want to see this. 1 second, 2 seconds, work, 3 seconds. Yeah, okay, we're on 3 seconds, and he's still. No, don't tell me they're going to be a continue to the next episode.
There is no way.
I don't think so. I don't know.
See ya.
He's like, peace. Oh, he didn't God. Stop. Oh well.
He actually did it. It actually worked.
Oh. I'm blown away by the insanity. I'm blown away by the insanity.
That was really
just
cool.
It's pretty impressive, to say the least. Pretty impressive. You don't want to mess with this guy in the alley, apparently. That's what I hear. Have you heard about this guy?
I don't think so.
So apparently you don't want to mess with this guy in the alley. I like him already. Dude, it's another Kung Fu Master.
It is.
Yeah, I'm telling you, Kung Fu Master.
Yeah. Oh. That's the chi right there.
Oh, yeah. I can see it. He used to sing for Zeppelin, I think.
My God, is that Jason Bourne?
That's unbelievable. That's unbelievable. I can't believe that we witnessed this today on the show. Unbelievable. This guy is a master of Kung Fu and Karate. Yeah, unbelievable. Unbelievable. Wow. I can't handle watching it again. His skills are so good that my eyes might blink. Uh-huh. Okay,
I understand.
I think you have a question for me. Would I mm-hmm. eat this food? Would I eat this food?
And I don't know. I don't know these answers. I mean, some of them I do, and I just put it out there because I know he'll eat it.
The way that this...
I think I've seen this one, and 100% would eat it.
My entire existence.
I have.
Okay, so... I kind of want to tell you something, but I want to see if she does what I'm thinking she's going to do.
Absolutely insane. I cannot...
Does this include a frozen dessert?
Yeah, it includes ice cream.
That's what I was saying.
She covers
dessert.
Believe
she covers that.
I have eaten.
Yes, that's what I was saying.
Ice cream and it becomes crunchy.
Yes. Now, one of my favorite guys did this, and you know what he put on it?
Horrifying.
Okay, well let's see what she does, and then I'll tell you what the guy I follow did. Because I think it's going to be next level to what she does. I think hers is going to be here. I think his is here.
Snap.
Yeah, I get it.
Okay, what are you putting on there? What are you putting on there?
Vanilla.
What kind of ice cream?
Vanilla.
Yeah, well, you're guessing it's vanilla. It could be butter pistachio, pecan.
But seriously, it's
okay.
So good.
All right, it's poppy hazelnut.
My choice is
crunch.
Strawberry.
I don't know.
I just want to know. Tell me what it is.
Roll-ups.
Well, at least
it's
the
ice cream.
Oh, you can hear it.
Yeah.
Never stop. There is no sweet treat.
I gotta do
better.
This. How to do this.
It's okay. Really good.
Oh, sounds so good. I love that expression at the end.
Yes.
Speaking of which, let's do that as a snapshot. You ready? Let me see if I can get her queued up to that same spot. Okay.
No,
all three of us, we'll do it at the same time.
Treat.
Three,
better
two,
yeah.
One.
This, okay.
Here we go.
Oh my God. The way.
Okay, there we go.
That this.
The way.
The way that this works out is so amazing. Okay, so just on a side note, for anybody that's doing that, the guy that I watched, he took forget which flavor of fruit roll up it was, but he put mango gelato or mango sherbet in it. Then he put hot sauce on it and tahini. And then he wrapped it up, and then he ate it, and he put more hot sauce on it. And he said it was amazing. He said it was absolutely amazing. He was blown away because he thought it was going to suck. He was like, this is going to be horrible. 100% I would eat that, by the way. 100%. What about you? You've already eaten it. So
I've already have. It's good.
Yeah, so yep. Percentage wise, you're already at 100. Let's see. Would I eat this? Here's the next one. Let me see if I'll eat this one. Oh, come on. Take me to the place. Take me to the place with the people.
So SpongeBob meme.
Oh, the video's unavailable?
Sorry about that. Well, it has been a couple of days. Okay, yum. Yum part one and yum part two.
Yum, yum.
Now let's see if you agree with my yum and if we actually can see this TikTok. Because you know how tiki-takis are. Tiki-takis. Burn it now. Come on. Here we go.
So today I'm about to show you how to make some prison.
This is my guy,
Oreo
by the way.
McFlurry.
Prison Oreo McFlurry. Yeah. You can't even get a McFlurry at McDonald's. How you get one in prison? Milk, creamer. What are you doing with that?
Creamer.
You're gonna mix it up. I swear they'd be making everything in jail except for good decisions. Are you gonna pour it in a bag? Okay. Salt on ice.
Salt.
Then you're gonna put
on ice.
Bag, okay.
Yes.
Okay.
That's
and
how
then,
you make stuff.
Okay. He's got a blanket. He's gonna
pause
tuck it in
real
like
quick.
It's nighttime.
Okay. So when you're making homemade ice cream, you basically take ice and you put rock salt on it, and then you spin the ice cream.
Okay.
Because of the salt, the ice goes way lower in temperature. That's our science tip for the day.
Shake it for 5 minutes, because y'all got nothing but time in that. Okay. Oreos, crush them up, and then what? Then you get.
And now you got a prison style Oreo McFlurry.
That looks like concrete.
Welcome back to McPrison. I'm your host, Ronald. We got our milk. Don't ask me how much because they don't have measuring cups in jail. From jailmate to coffee mate, here we go. I'm just going to pour. I got the French vanilla because I'm outside the bars and I can do whatever I want. So I'm going to get crazy with it, okay? I have no idea what we're doing here, folks. You can't even go down the street to McDonald's to get a McFlurry because the ice cream machine is broken.
Ice machine is always broken.
A McFlurry in a McHurry? Make that make sense. Last week we made Jailhouse Laffy Taffy. This week we're making McFlurries. I'm about to make a whole damn cookbook. Call it The Simple Pleasures of the Penitentiary. Welcome back to Simple Pleasures from the Penitentiary. I'm your host, Yanni from the yard.
Hey, baby, what's going on?
The salt in there. Tell you what, if I was in jail, they call me Salt.
Perfect use of a sound effect.
On second thought, I don't want to be nobody's bag. He used a prison blanket. I'm using a Mickey Mouse blanket because Disney World is the closest thing I've ever been to jail. And now I'm going to shake it for 5 minutes.
His shaking skills are good. Strong.
Well, I thought I heard the guards. I was about to mix scurry.
See what you did there?
McMurder me in jail. Okay.
Oh yeah, they would.
Beat your Oreos like you're beating your, like you're trying to beat, like you're beating your case, your court case. Beat your Oreos like you're. Huh? Welcome back to Did It Work? I'm incarcerated, Earl. It's chunky. No way. There's no way. No way. No way.
No way. No way. No way.
Get out of
prison.
Look at this. Look at this.
Look.
Get out of town. No way. Welcome back to Would You McMurder for McFlurry. I'm your host, Shanky Sean. Wow. That I am absolutely flabbergasted. Look at how amazing that worked. One, two. Are you kidding me? Okay, take me to jail and call me Jane, because this is insane. This is, I tell you what, it gets delicious on D-Block.
You don't want to go on the D-Block.
No. You want to avoid D-Block.
I swallowed the nut, and I'm not supposed to.
Definitely not supposed to swallow not on D block. Nope.
Just
nope.
A word of caution. They should have just, this on the bag. No deep throating the nuts.
On D block.
Yeah, no.
Ice cream instead of cheese.
Okay, this is the one I was telling you about.
Okay.
It's the exact same one as before. But let me jump forward to like where he starts to do it.
Yes.
Okay, so this is he took a, get over there. He took a green one. Get over there.
Mango sorbet.
Mango sorbet on a green one.
Sorbet.
And I love the Valentinas. That's my favorite hot sauce, by the way.
I got you.
For this one. Wait a minute. Mm. Oh, God. Oh, man.
Oh, Jesus Christ. How is that so good? There's so many things going on in my mouth right.
What? Background. The cat just walked over the stove.
I was supposed to be a little Boricua, baby. I know, I can feel it in my body. Should have been Jose. But nope, I'm just Gringo Corey.
Apparently, if you put ice cream instead of a fruit roll-up, it gets...
I'm just surprised we both had one on this show this week. Crunch,
yeah,
crunch.
Yeah, well,
crunch.
You know.
Ride! Are you ready to ride? I'm ready to roll.
Mm-hmm.
Ready to ride, ready to roll.
I am.
Welcome back.
Would you ride this?
Well, that ride was
first
a bit
of all
timid.
Probably no.
At least it's time now to get off. Apparently, little jolt there. Okay, let's get up. Ah!
Nope. I think they broke the Indiana Jones ride.
At least it's time now to get off.
See, I've been on a ride that's like this, but it doesn't do that droppy thing. Okay. So, a lot of the... just doesn't look good. Looks like you're about to get murdered. So, a lot of the loop-de-loop rides, like, that's all they did, was they looped, and then they stopped, and then they looped back. And the way that they would go the other direction was always creepy, because it did, like, this little, like... thing.
Yes.
And you're like, I'm gonna die! And then you go backwards.
Right.
And you die backwards, I guess, apparently.
Uh-huh.
And no. The answer to that question is no.
Negative.
No. Okay, no. Music section. We are entering the music section. We don't have any music section sound. We need a music section sound. We need Fitz to make us music section sound. Note.
Yeah.
Note to self and to Fitz. We're doing music because... we have music on the show. This is a mashup, everybody. This is mashup. And we'll see how many of these we can get through. I got like 150 of here on here. So
we do.
Oh, I can't stop laughing. For anybody that's too young to know what that is a Richard Simmons, everyone. I love how it's timed the same. Like,
this is so perfect.
It is. I'd go to that spin class. I mean, I'd go to that step aerobics.
I would too. Right. Sweating is some tool.
Yep.
With Maynard. With Maynard and Simmons. Yeah.
Wow. That's impressive, if you ask me. Oh, too funny. That is too funny.
That's perfect.
Oh, that was good. That was a little bit too perfect. It's kind of creepy.
Oh my gosh.
So now yours is just called music. Yours is just music.
Yeah, this is just music.
Just music. Don't get twisted, people. Don't get twisted.
No. But if I was walking down the street and saw this, I would stop.
Dude, on the street, that's amazing.
Yes.
I would oh my gosh, I like that guy. That guy, the 60s and that guy were friends. Like, real good friends. You know what I mean? Look at that guy dancing.
And this is a hard song to cover, too.
It is. Oh my gosh, he's doing amazing.
It's perfect!
That is. Holy crap. How in the hell? Mexico City, everybody.
Yeah.
I thought our street performers were good. That street performer is like, holy mackerel.
That was next level.
Well,
I would have been like,
yeah.
Is System of a Down here? Because System of a Down.
Here is my 20 pesos. Was that a nickel? Oh, crap. Okay, here's 100 pesos. Right. It's $2. Oh, crap. I wanted to give you actual money. Wait a second here. Oh, man. Wait for Wait for it. So funny enough, that one's probably going to kick the crap out of mine. I said, why can't all songs be this good? And I'll be honest, that one was better. So, or at least I'm just saying that now before we even get into it.
Ooh, the animals. I love the animals.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood. A beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Would you be mine? Could you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood. Neighborly day for beauty. Would you be mine? Would you be mine? Could you be mine?
I liked it too. I thought that was
so good.
Yeah, I was shocked when I came across it. So, oh, okay. We have been trying to get on Omegle forever. I'm going to figure it out one of these days, I swear. But when we go on Omegle, I want to run into this dude. He likes guitars. That's all I'm going to say about this guy. Okay. He likes guitars. Come on, bring it. Bring it.
Hey, what's up?
Give me some good.
Something good.
Give me something good.
This one's called Carol of the Bell.
I like how she smiles. She's like, yeah, that's not bad. That's not bad.
You know, that reaction is what he's hoping, like, if, like, his pants drop, and she was just like, oh my god.
So good. So good.
Don't look at it in the eye. Don't look at it in the eye.
It will steal your soul. Well, I thought she was pretty mean at the end. I thought her expressions were perfect until the very end, because I did watch this once.
I could do that too.
See? Liar. Wait,
excuse me?
Lies. Lie. I want to see you do that then.
No.
Make it happen.
Yeah.
Liar.
I want to see that too.
I do too. So
because
important...
both of my brain doesn't work with like that. Like I wouldn't be able to do both hands and like that. That
I mean, I juggle, and so I had to learn that. But it's still no. I'm just saying, I'm still not good at it. That's what I was trying to say. I hadn't even gotten to that part yet because I'm not good at it. So important news story for anybody that is. No, I don't want to pay for your service. What service you want me to pay for again? No, I don't want to subscribe. Oh, really? This is how you're going to play me today? New York Times going to play me like this? Okay, fine.
Yep.
You can play me like that, and I'll do this. Yep. In the background, you can see it. Afro man is sued by police officers after using their faces in a music video. So, since that happened, what we are going to do is we're going to play that music. Play that funky music, white boy. Because I was pretty mad when I heard about this. So, Afro man, for anybody, I'll tell you the story. So Afro Man was raided because apparently he has legal stuff at his house, apparently. So they knocked down his front gate, like knocked it down, and searched his whole house, disconnected some of his security cameras, and they took money from him. And this is the funniest part. So I don't have any money for demonstration, but I'll use imaginary money. The cops were like, one, two, three, over for you. Five, seven, over for you. Eight, nine, pocket. I mean, it's on video. Like, he literally has them on video doing that.
Wow.
And and they're like, well, the count that was there was right, but then it changed when it got here because that's the way our counting system works. That's how we do math. Oh, and the best part, they didn't find a damn thing.
What's the
Not a damn thing. They found nothing. Nothing.
Well, that sucks.
No, that's good for him. You don't want them to find nothing. Everybody turn their heads sideways.
Is this the song?
Yes. And that's all the cops raiding his house. He's got some dope cars, I'll tell you that much.
Why are they, I mean, did they really think something was going on?
They thought
that's
he had guns, drugs, and money, and they thought he had a lot of weed. He is the guy that's saying a song called I Would Have Done It But I Got High. Repair my gate? Will you help me repair my door? They busted his door too.
Did you find what you was looking for? Will you help me repair
And that's pretty much the song, everybody. It goes on like that.
Would you like a slice of lemon pound cake? You can eat as much as you want to take. There must be a big mistake. Would you like to have a slice of my lemon pound cake?
I think he wants some of that cake.
The warrant said narcotics and kidnapping.
That's the funniest part.
The
kidnapping.
The warrant said narcotics and kidnapping. Are you kidding? I make my money rapping. Why does the warrant say narcotics? Well, I know narcotics, but why kidnapping?
I know why narcotics. I know why that is. Yeah, I get it. I smoke weed. I smoke a lot of weed.
I was gonna go to class, but I got high.
But I got high. And another Kevin Smith reference. That song was used in Jay and Silent Bob.
Yeah,
I'm gonna sneeze.
Hey everybody on TikTok, you should go over to our YouTube, which is TP Show. It's TP/Show. TP Dash Show? Yeah, I think so.
TP like Dash that. Show. But if you just put in TP space SHOE, it'll take you to it. Yes, it will.
And then you guys will be able to see what's going on, and you guys will be able to participate, and you can leave comments. And yeah, everything is great, and you'll know why we're laughing, because you'll actually see the show live
and you'll hear it. We should have tested everything at once. Yeah, we should have. I think I put, this is our new singer. Yes, this is our newest singer for our band. This is the tryout. I think you'll dig her tryout.
All right,
everybody, I'm gonna sing right now for one time.
Let it go.
You're very welcome. You're very, very welcome.
I like it.
Yep,
I like it a lot.
That is our newest singer.
That's our newest singer.
Yes. Yep. And if you've never seen Star Trek The Next Generation, you're really missing out on a really good show. That's where I was introduced to this actor. He is an actor of note. And I think you'll enjoy his singing as well.
Keep rolling, rolling, rolling.
Oh, yes.
The streams are swollen. Keep them doggies rolling rawhide. Through rain and wind and weather, hell-bent leather, wishing my gal was by my side.
Cut them out, ride them in, ride them in, let them out, cut them out.
Ride them in rawhide.
I like it.
I do too. I think it's awesome. And so that leads us to Metal Mind Melter.
Neil Patrick Stewart was really cool.
Yes. Neil Heyman from the he's good too. Neil Heyman is good.
All right.
Metal Mind Melter.
Cool. Actually a band that's not like, so this one's more like
Metal Mind Melter by Rob Wagner. It's widely publicized that the early 90s were not kind to the genre of metal. We all know that the Seattle scene played a key role in the thinning of the metal herd. Metal got pushed back underground from whence it emerged. I admittedly embraced the likes of Nirvana, STP, Alice in Chains, and Soundgarden, while a significant number of metal bands threw in the towel after being dropped from their record labels. The year was 1994, and I was working for an alternative rock station in Philly. I was known by the record reps as the metal guy at the station. They would hook me up with releases by the heavier side of alternative with the hopes I could influence the station to go harder. I remember one such rep coming to me with boundless enthusiasm for a band called Korn. He told me I would love it. Honestly, I didn't, and I didn't connect with it at all. As I listened to Chutes and Ladders, I remember thinking, Nick, Knack, Patty, Whack, what the f*** is this? Romper Room was canceled years ago. Cut to 1998, and I heard Got the Light. Okay, I thought, this is pretty good, but I still don't get this rap infusion. A few years after that, and I heard Right Now, and I pulled a 180. Angry and heavy as shit. I bought the album and loved it. Then I bought Greatest Hits and rediscovered a treasure trove of unique and imaginative music. One of the greatest shows I've ever attended was Snoop Dogg, Korn, and Linkin Park. Of the genre of nu metal, I only really truly understood Korn and Linkin Park. I am still proud that I contributed to the booing of Limp Bizkit off the stage at the Electric Factory when they opened for Faith No More in 1998. As a longtime Korn fan, I still get the chills hearing the bagpipes from Blind and the opening riffs of Here to Stay. Although I am partial to Take a Look in the Mirror, Greatest Hits is definitely my go-to for them. I'm glad I saw the light and remain a fan to this day. Korn, Greatest Hits. Word up, Another Brick in the Wall, parts 1, 2, and 3. Y'all want a single? Right Now, Did My Time, Alone I Break, Here to Stay, Trash, Somebody, Someone, Make Me Bad, Falling Away from Me, Got the Life, Freak on a Leash, Twist, Adidas, Clown, Chutes and Ladders, Blind, and Freak on a Leash. This week's band, Korn.
Korn. So, I agree with his list, but it's in reverse order.
Oh, that's funny. So yeah. His list was, you're talking about the albums or are you talking about the songs?
Songs.
Yep.
Yeah. What's your favorite Korn album?
That's a good question. I think it's the one with the girl going up the
Follow the Leader. That was mine.
Yeah. Yeah. And I love Adidas. First time I ever heard Adidas, I laughed my ass off. It's just such a funny concept. All day I dream about sex. I'm sure Adidas was pissed.
Right.
I'll just be honest.
Oh, yeah.
I'm sure they're like, that's not what us Germans meant it to mean. Wilhelm, get it right. So, Korn, if you're listening, we're fans.
Korn,
we're big fans.
We're
if
fans.
You ever want to come on the show, just ask us. You don't even have to ask. Just show up. You're invited.
Mine was like 90s something, and it was the Family Values Tour. And it happened at, where did I see it at? It wasn't Staples Center. It wasn't Great Western Forum. It was Anaheim Stadium where the Mighty Ducks played.
Oh, yeah.
Across
from
Angel Stadium.
Yep.
But yeah, it was Family Values Tour. And I saw Ramstein.
Oh, yeah.
And Limp Bizkit. And I think Ice Cube was there.
Now, was Ramstein the headliner, though? The reason I ask is because when they're a headliner, their show is, like, even higher than it normally is.
No.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, they were, like...
Third?
Yeah.
Who was the headliner? Do you remember? And,
it was Korn and Limp Bizkit. They were both,
Oh, they were doing the duo. Yeah. Co-headliners.
Like, everybody came up. Yeah. But the Ramstein guy took out, like, a fake wiener and peed all over everybody.
I believe it.
That sounds really weird.
That sounds like Ramstein. They're a weird, twisted German band. I'll tell you that much. The one thing I was going to say
Ice Cube
is
came out too, and he came out with Korn, and they did a song together, and it was cool.
That sounds amazing.
I was going to say
Limp Bizkit. No, not Limp Bizkit. No. Linkin Park. Linkin Park just had an
Linkin
album
Park.
Come out. I mean, it just came out like a month ago. I was like,
and they have
away.
Another one hit song that it was like a non-release song from that album. And now it's number one.
I love it when stuff like that happens. I'll just be honest. I'm a huge fan of theirs. I mean, I've always been a huge fan. And his death was very jarring to me, to say the least.
I haven't been the biggest of Linkin Park fan. But yeah.
Okay. So as fandom goes, I like their hit songs. Do you know what I mean? I'm not deep diving into that catalog. Just saying. Not deep diving into their catalog. I think they make good music, but I'm not like, I'm not a mega fan. I am not a Spinal Tap fan. I'm not at that level.
I get it. And I can see how people like them and stuff like that. And like, mm-hmm. there's some songs that I'm like, yeah, it's really cool. But I don't know. It's one of those things where there was just so many like rap rock bands.
Yeah, the crossover. My favorite out of that was Papa Roach. Like that Papa Roach like song where they're in the strong, like, oh yeah, they are. And they were in like a boxing ring or something and they had all their fans around them and they did like 360 looping cam. Yes. I was like, wow, this video is innovative and this song is amazing. So, but that's like 14 decades ago. Like you have to be 170 to know what I'm talking about.
I still remember Crazy Town. So,
yeah. That's true. apparently. See, I was big into I was a big fan of Anthrax. So when some of that stuff came out, I'm like,
oh, yeah. Well, no, I get it because I was dating a girl that like Butterfly was like her favorite song, and I bought the album, and I'm like, the rest of the album's awesome. Butterfly sucks. Like, what the hell? Yeah.
I think there's a horrible, tragic story with that band, too. But I don't know.
I'm sure there is.
Apparently, you can't watch anything you want on an airplane anymore. You just can't watch anything you want. Apparently.
Oh, no. What are you doing? What?
Okay, hold on. I've got something to say about this, though. I got something to say.
What do you have to say about this video?
That's in the headrest. You can't get a headrest video unless it's piped through the overhead. Meaning that's not him watching an iPad. That's him watching a movie that they provided for him.
Right.
You're providing these movies, and how old is that kid?
You know what I think it is? I think that's that Star Series or whatever P-Town is, whatever that's
It is. It is. I think you're right. And that kid is getting an
education.
Oh yeah, this is stripper 101 class. Everybody at home, stripper 101 class.
Yeah. Oh,
holy Morocco's and Batman.
The mom doesn't even care, or whoever is with them, like does not even.
Oh well, that's because they're watching their own porn over there. You notice they're like they didn't take their eyes off of whatever they're watching the whole time. What are you gonna say to the guy though? Excuse me, sir. Could you please not watch your videos? I do not appreciate them.
Can you please keep your whore into yourself when you get home?
Oh, I've got one that's even better. What would have been even more hilarious is if the mom pulled out a stack of ones and just started going like this at the screen. Mom for the win.
Chris Rock is behind the kid and he taps him on the shoulder. There's no sex in the champagne room. There's not.
Don't pay the extra.
No.
Okay, so this kid reminds me of a very old Italian man. Very old Italian man.
Bangul.
That's what it looks like he's saying, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Get out of here. Bangul, get out of here. I look like Grandpa, and Grandpa does this. A fungul, a yulo, a fungul, a get out of here, get out of here. Like the mom's laugh too. Gabagool, gabagool. I love the mom's laugh too. Like,
see, that's an Office reference. And see, you just got to go deep into the Office.
Well, you see, that was a reference from before that, though. Gabagool.
Yeah.
But
they go to an Italian restaurant.
Yes.
And Dwight's like talking to Michael, and Michael's like, I don't know what to order in an Italian restaurant. And he's like, you got to order the gabagool, or it's not a real Italian restaurant. And so Michael gets there and he's like, I want the gabagool. She's like, the what? We don't have no
gabagool.
he's like, then I want a salad with the salad dressing on the top. And if it's not on the top, I'm going to send it back.
Thank you for watching this segment of the TP Show. Please follow us on Fruit Lab. Don't forget we have a podcast on your favorite podcast app. This has been another installment of the TP Show.